Therefore, we have three and not only one differences between conventional energies and renewable energies. The conventional energies lead automatically. There is no way out to more and more uncarryable energy dependency. There's no way out. As long we are dependent on this, we use this, we insist to go on, we keep these energies for our energy consumption, it leads to more and more energy dependency, and that means to more and more political dependency, to more and more dependency on the pricings of the suppliers, of the few energy promoting exporting countries, few and fewer transnational energy corporations, their price dictates, and more dependency of some technologies and their dangers and all the follow-ups. It is dependency of a whole society and its economy and in a very unique way, because one point is totally for sure for all: without energy nothing works. Therefore it is not one element among others. It is a basic element for all what we are doing. And if this basic element leads to such dependencies, we become dependent in principle, in all what we are doing. And therefore, it is necessary to understand that the way, the possibility for energy autonomy, that means to become released from all these dependencies, is only possible for all with renewable energies. Only with this, because of the heritage, the way we can harvest, we can win, we can promote these sources. And this has to do with the third difference. Discussed are only today, in the most cases, the first and the second difference. The first difference is very well known. Here you have the conventional energies which are exhaustible. That means the day comes when it is over, and the party is over. The day comes sooner than many people think. And on the other side, you have the renewable energies, which are energies forever. One difference. Second difference, here you have the polluting energies, or the fossil and nuclear energies. CO2 is not the only polluting element, not the only. There are a lot of others. And the range of the polluting elements, which endangers the cycles of nature and our life, is from CO2 to nuclear waste, and in between a lot of other things. And on the other side, we have with renewable energy the unique chance for a clean energy solution, energy free of emissions, free of pollutions. And this chance is unique, like the chance to have energy forever. Now comes the third element. And without understanding the third element, nobody can understand the resistances against renewable energies. Nobody can understand the right concepts, the right strategies, the right ways, and the right technologies. This has to do with the differences, the structural differences of the energy sources. Energy consumption is always decentralized, where people work and live, in higher densities or lower densities, dependent on the settlement of the development of the economy and so forth. Finally, the energy consumption end comes to an individual person or individual factory or in a house, finally. or the automotive or an airplane. Decentralized, everywhere, for more than 6 billion people. And the energy production of conventional energies happens at fewer and fewer places in the world. In the run of the exhausting, the places become fewer and fewer, because the exhaustion happens not in the same time everywhere. Some sources are exploited, some not. And more come to the exploitation. That means the whole system becomes more and more centralized in the mining, in the phase, in the starting phase of mining and extraction of oil and gas, and mining of coal and uranium.